Okay, we're now in our counting room, and this is the liquid nitrogen that's used to keep the high-purity germanium detector cold while it's operating. And I'll show you how we load the samples. Okay, what we do in order to fix the geometry, we have stands, is what we call them. And we put these over the detector, and then we can add our cobalt check source like that, so we have a fixed geometry. I'll roll back the piece of lead, and the whole thing goes inside. And we're ready to go collect a spectrum. As you can see here, the cobalt 60 is growing in. Here are the two peaks, but now it's fully resolved between the two peaks. They separate, are clearly separated from each other. Notice how much better the resolution is here. This is great. Let's go add a cesium source to it, and then we'll watch the cesium grow in too. All right, now we've got cobalt 60. I can add my cesium source. Again, I know the geometry. And we can go look and see how the cesium grows in. All right, now we see the cesium growing in too. So we have energy calibrations here. And so we will use these points and construct an energy calibration. To construct our absolute efficiency calibrations, we're not going to use these check sources. We have a europium NIST traceable source, and we're going to put that in, and then we can construct the absolute efficiency of our detector for stand 3. Here's our mixed gamma NIST traceable source . Being careful to add it in the same geometry. And now we have a dozen lines that are going to show up on our spectrum that we can use to do a complete energy calibration and an absolute efficiency calibration. Let's watch this. And here you can see, oh my gosh, there's a dozen peaks here. And we know the yields very well, and it's built into the library. We're going to let this count for a minute, and then we're going to use the software as a part of our counting system to construct the absolute efficiency curve for us. Let's watch it build in for a minute, and this is like watching paint dry. And now we feed this data to the software, and voila, here is our absolute efficiency curve. Seems simple, doesn't it? Okay, you are now trained and you're ready to run into the lab and do this yourself.